I was born in Iraq, 1965, and south of Iraq. I grew up, I'm one of the 10 of my family, 5 brothers, 5 sisters that I have. I have two of them in here, a sister and brother. I came to the state in 92. And I was in Iraq and Iraqi army before, and the Iraq-Iran war, and after that in Desert Storm, which is that I didn't believe. That's why I fled to the US, going to Saudi Arabia, the refugee camp for 2.5 years, and I came to the state, to Boston. I worked as a dry cleaner, and I and then as an electrician, and then I got a call or an email, both of them, to be a linguist, and I wanted to do it to help my country and to help the my country in here and my country in Iraq, to help the soldier up there for as a culture advisor or a linguist, or to make things better in Iraq, to make a difference in my life too, and make a difference in Iraqi lives. That's what I thought, that will help both countries, and I appreciate them both. I have a good experience at be a linguist with the Marines and the Army together. They both did a great job to improve Iraqi life up there. You know, it just like I said, it's no freedom without blood, and it just like, that's what I get that tattoo in here for my 5 guys that I killed, one of my interpreter and one and 5 soldiers, and which is that memorial tattoo for them, that in my hand, which is is gonna stay forever. Yeah, I love these guys, and they were my unit, and the guy interpreter, he was my roommate, and we always exchange between us to go on, you know, every other day mission. So that mission was mine, but it changed, and he went. So I don't know, I was lucky, maybe. I don't know what happened, but it just happened. I've been living in here, very good life. I have 2 kids and a wife, wonderful wife, and just I went, served for 2 years, and coming back in here, and I hope I can find a job in here again. So because I know with the economy, it's so hard to find a job. The hardest part I've been in Iraq, that I left it, it was nice, and I came, it was destroyed, but it's getting better right now. And the hardest thing when I see something explode, a car or a guy or something, to kill these innocent people, that's the hardest part. You know, and the happiest part that I told you about, that little kid, a binal kid, that he was, we were there, and he can't get to us because he can't be in the sun, he can't see. So I asked him, and he told me that he can't see in the sun. So I gave him 2 pair of glasses, sunglasses, and he was fine, and he came back, he went with the kids and played with the kids, and that made me happy. That was very good, I think.